what you think.
What is up, guys? In today's video, we will be talking about former Tennessee star Jarnell Stokes and why he failed to make it in the NBA. If you love college basketball, be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you love these type of videos, make sure to check out my playlist of them in the description below. And now let's get started with today's video. Jarnell Stokes grew up in the inner city of Memphis, Tennessee. His father was a military man, so the family didn't put up with a lot of nonsense. He grew up in a not-so-nice area, and the gang culture claimed a lot of kids around him, but Jarnell wanted to play basketball at a high level, so he stayed away from all that kind of stuff. He pushed himself on the AAU circuit and in his high school gym. He said as a kid he was raised not to show emotion and to have a killer instinct every time he stepped on the court. As he got older, he was one of the better players on the court and began to get noticed as a prospect. By the time he was a junior, he boasted offers from schools such as Florida, Kentucky, UConn, Memphis, and Tennessee. He was a 5-star recruit, but he couldn't exactly go wherever he wanted right away. After a transfer before his junior year, he was ruled ineligible and had a decision to make. Would he wait a year and play for Kentucky, an elite school that could put him in the NBA? Stay home and play for Memphis, a prestigious program and a hometown hero? Or would he graduate early and enroll at Tennessee? He chose the latter and became a Tennessee Volunteer. As a recruit, he would have been a 5-star recruit had he stayed in the 2012 class, but he's now only a 4-star recruit and the number 41 overall player in the class of 2011. Tennessee was in their first season under head coach Conzo Martin, who is now the head coach at Missouri. Joining Stokes was a roster that included Jordan McRae, Jerome Maimon, and Trey Golden. Since Stokes didn't play until second semester, Tennessee would be without their best post player for the beginning of the season. It showed as they started out the season 7-7 with bad losses to Austin Peay, Charleston, and Oakland. Martin held Stokes out of the first two SEC games, but when he returned, his presence was immediately felt. In his third game against number 13 UConn, Stokes put up 16 points and 12 rebounds and led Tennessee to a win. From there, Tennessee went back on a run to save their season. They won 9 of their last 12 games to finish with a 9-6 SEC record and a 17-13 overall record. They got themselves back on the bubble, but they would need a win in the SEC tournament to solidify a spot in the field. Sadly, it didn't play out that way, as they lost a close game to Ole Miss in overtime. They ended up becoming the number 1 seed in the NIT, and they beat Savannah State in the first round. They ended up falling to in-state foe Middle Tennessee in the next round, and finished with a 19-5 overall record. Stokes had a huge freshman year. He caused a shift in a losing team that was almost enough to get them into the NCAA tournament. He started 14 of his 17 games and scored in double figures in 8 of them. On the year, he averaged 9.6 points, 7.4 rebounds, and 1.4 blocks a night while shooting 53% from the field. Going into his sophomore year, the team returned the core of McRae, Stokes, and Golden, and expectations were high in Knoxville. The Vols began the season 8-4, with a win over Wichita State and losses to Oklahoma State, Georgetown, Virginia, and rival Memphis. In the Memphis game, Stokes had 11 points and 9 rebounds. Just like last year, they got off to a rough start in SEC play as they dropped their first 3 games and had an 8-7 overall record. Then the Vols got hot. Just like last year, they went on a winning streak where they won 8 of their next 11 games with wins over Kentucky and Florida. After that, they won 2 of their last 3 games to finish with an 11-7 record in the SEC. During that streak, Stokes scored in double figures and was the catalyst in their run. After beating Mississippi State, they lost to a bad Alabama team and it was going to be a nerve-wracking selection Sunday for them. They ended up having to settle for the NIT once again, and they lost to Mercer in the first round to finish with a 20-13 overall record. On the year, Stokes averaged 12.4 points, 9.6 rebounds, and a block a night, and he was predicted to be a second-round pick. Jarnell ended up declining that opportunity and came back to school for his junior year. Going into his junior season, the Tennessee fanbase had officially put a ton of pressure on Conzo Martin and the team to bring them back to the NCAA tournament. The trio of Jordan McRae, Jarnell Stokes, and Josh Richardson were expected to make some noise. They began the season 9-4 with wins over Xavier and Virginia, but they also lost to Xavier, Wichita State, NC State, and a terrible loss to UTEP. As they went into SEC play, they were super inconsistent, as they would win a game here and there, and then lose one basically every week. At this point, they hadn't beaten anybody good in the SEC, but they get into the tournament based on quantity of wins, not quality. They finished the season with 4 straight wins, including a win over fellow bubble team Missouri, which basically eliminated them from competition. They went 1-1 in the SEC tournament, and got a bid to play in the first 4 in Dayton. After beating Iowa in overtime, they went on to beat UMass and Mercer to make it to the Sweet 16. They ended up falling a bucket short against Michigan, and their miracle run was over. On the year, Stokes averaged 15 points, 10.6 rebounds, and a block a night while becoming a member of the SEC first team. After the season, Konzo Martin left for California, and Jarnell left for the NBA. Scouts saw Stokes as a one-dimensional post player that was undersized for his position in the NBA. Three-pointers were not as important back then, so if he was in this year's class, he would have been knocked on even more. Before he could even be drafted, he got in a serious car accident, and his basketball career was in jeopardy. Thankfully, he was okay, and he ended up being drafted with the 35th overall pick to the Utah Jazz. Later, he was traded to his hometown team, the Memphis Grizzlies, and he locked up a multi-year deal with them. During his rookie season, he only managed to score 3 points a game and had a season high of 12. At the beginning of his second year, he was traded to the Miami Heat, and he was reunited with his former teammate Josh Richardson. Since then, he has spent a ton of time with the Sioux Falls Skyforce and various international teams. Currently, he plays in China, and I expect him to continue to try and make it back to the NBA. Overall, I think Jarnell Stokes is a really good basketball player, but he's just in the wrong era. He's a traditional big man with no three-point range. He plays hard and has an insane work ethic, so he'll always have a fighting chance wherever he goes, but I just don't know if he'll ever make it and have a role in today's NBA. I really enjoyed watching Jarnell in college. I hope the best for moving forward. If you enjoyed today's video about him, make sure to hit that like button. And if you like these type of videos, check out both my videos on the screen and in the description below. Peace.